And joining me now is Republican Representative Mike Gallagher of Wisconsin. Representative Gallagher, thank you so much for your time today. Great to see you. A lot to talk about. But first, as we just heard and as you know, the House passed a budget bill along party lines to raise the debt ceiling. I'd like to get your thoughts on that and what you think comes next.
Well, I think it's a mistake to consider these two bills separately. One, we've been out of session for 7 weeks. We've been in session for 3 days in the last 7 weeks. We come back and then Speaker Pelosi tries to jam a continuing resolution with a debt ceiling increase down our throats. It makes absolutely no sense. This is something we should have been working on the last few months, and it's a political move. She just wants to have Republican cover for making room for passing a upwards of $5 trillion increase in federal spending. And that leads us to the infrastructure bill and the Bernie Sanders socialist spending spree. This is going to be a mad dash to see how much money can be spent in the next few weeks. And I think you have to consider both of these bills as effectively one bill. Right now, we don't know if the Democrats are going to get the votes to pass one or the other. But I really think we need to take a step back and consider how broken our budget process is and just how much money we're adding to the federal debt. I think it's going to have damaging long-term consequences.
Yeah, and talking about that human infrastructure bill, there is a lot jam-packed in there. But one thing that isn't in there is pro-life protections. Can you talk about that?
Yeah, you know, it used to be, you know, though the parties disagreed on the issue of abortion, there was agreement on the Hyde Amendment that no federal taxpayer dollars would go towards abortion. And unfortunately, the Democrats have completely abandoned that those provisions, abandoned the Hyde Amendment protections, and this bill has no Hyde Amendment protections. And if you couple that with some of the bills that they're going to be putting on the House floor as a standalone bill that would allow abortion until the moment of birth, they've really adopted a very extreme position. I mean, this goes well beyond Roe versus Wade. It allows discriminatory abortions on the basis of a baby's sex, race, and disability. It's really unconscionable. All of these bills are really bad bills, and I think anyone who's pro-life needs to fight as hard as possible against them.
Absolutely. Very concerning indeed. On a different topic, I understand you are a co-chair of the Friends of Australia Caucus. Can you talk to us more about that, and also, if you will, the strategic military alliance that formed between the U.S., UK, and Australia, and the importance of it?
Well, Australia's really been at the leading edge of competition with China. They've been the subject of withering economic coercion from China after they had the temerity to suggest that we need an investigation into the origins of coronavirus. And years before, when they started to pass laws to get at the issue of Chinese influence in their domestic politics, the Chinese have done everything to intimidate them, harass them, and economically coerce them. And they're standing strong. I think they're providing an example for us, and we need to stand with them. For over 100 years, we fought side by side in every war. Americans and Aussies have fought together. As co-chair of the Friends of Australia Caucus, I see the benefits of this alliance every single day. And this latest agreement that's being called AUKUS, I think is a good agreement. I think it's a chance to enhance our cooperation, particularly on defense issues. I think it's a big win. We're going to be helping them with nuclear sub technology, some missile development technology, and ultimately that's going to improve our ability to stand up to China together with our allies. So this is a big win for the United States, and we need to make sure that we're supporting our mates in Australia.
Yeah, we have about a minute left or so, but I really want to talk about this. It's been about a month or so since the Taliban took control of Afghanistan, and so much has transpired since then. It's really almost too much to summarize. That said, could you give us your thoughts on how you see things playing out in Afghanistan now under Taliban rule and what that could mean for us here in the U.S., in particular for Homeland Security?
Well, we've abandoned hundreds of Americans behind enemy lines, and I've seen no plan from the Biden administration to rescue our own citizens, and many of the Afghans have fought with us. We've effectively abandoned them to a terrorist regime in Afghanistan. And I think what we're going to see more broadly is an increase in the threat from terrorism. Even General Milley, the chairman of the Joint Chiefs of Staff, admitted that al-Qaeda stands to benefit from our withdrawal. And so in some ways, I think we might see what we saw after the withdrawal, the precipitous political withdrawal from Iraq, which is that we have a massive increase in terrorist groups and increase in threats to the homeland. And that's why I oppose the withdrawal and why I think we're going to be in for a rough ride going forward.
Well, thank you so much for your time today. We have to wrap it up. Great to have you on. Representative Mike Gallagher, thank you again.
Thank you.